Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Windows 8 development, Windows 8 app development with the web platform. We are really excited. We've got tons of content today. My name is Jeremy Foster, and this is my buddy Michael.
Hi.
We are going to be covering some really cool topics over the next couple of days. And I hope that you guys just stay in your seats, and I hope you have a good time.
Yeah, I'm very excited about all the content that we're doing today. In fact, so much so, I know we both want to just dive in, but I think a good idea is to at least let you know who we are a little bit. I'd love to introduce you, Jeremy, and I'm going to let everyone know, Jeremy's been with Microsoft now almost a year. He's a member of our evangelism team, and the thing that I really enjoy about Jeremy, in fact, I think the reason why we connected and work so well is because we have a passion for this topic. But I love how much he is so fussy about the details on his blog and when he does any writing. So if you're really interested in understanding something, how it really works, and you want to see code written the right way, I think of Jeremy's. And I've learned a lot from you so far, so I'm excited that I'm doing this with you.
Well, just because it compiles and passes the unit tests doesn't necessarily mean that it's written right, right?
Right.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, I'm equally excited to be working with Michael. Michael is the author of multiple books and online videos that I have personally benefited from, so thank you for that. Michael's got lots of industry experience in the web. He is, in my opinion, rocking the web stack. So it's going to be good working with you here on screen.
Thanks.
So let me tell you what we've got in store for you. We've got a course that's going to last 2 days, and it is Accelerated Certification Prep Jumpstart. Why don't you break that down for him? What does that mean?
Well, you know, we do have the certification thing in there, but I think what is really exciting about what we're doing is that all the content that's going to be covered, which goes into this 7480, which is developing in HTML5 with JavaScript, and also the tomorrow's stuff, which is the 70-481, which is really creating the apps with it, all this content is really derived from real-world experience, from us being out in the trenches doing all these events. I absolutely love the fact that we're bringing this to the table and that it aligns so nicely with these certs.
Yeah, absolutely. It is an accelerated course, so we're not going to have hands-on labs. You've got the Code Show project that you're welcome to follow along on, but for the most part, we're going to be really moving through a lot of content. So we're going to kind of white-knuckle a little bit. The Code Show project is going to be pretty integral to what we're doing today. I'm going to jump out and show you this. If you go to codeshow.codeplex.com, and then go to the source code tab, not the downloads tab, because that's going to get you releases, which there are none right now. But just go to source code, and you're free to browse the source code online, or go over here to download and download that source code. That's available to you at any point. These are one-day versions of 5-day courses. What's normally done in 5 days, we're going to try to pack into 1 day each.
Yeah, so I mean, when we're saying accelerated, we really truly mean it. But if you are the type that really, really enjoys having that slower experience, then you should reach out to a Microsoft partner and look for these courses that they might be available. The 20480A. Boy, I couldn't even, that was a tongue twister. And 20481A. Both of these are courses that map to those exams.
Absolutely. So here's what we're going to be doing over the next couple of days. On the left, you see day one, and on the right, day two. So today, we're going to be sticking to the topics of the web platform. Pretty generic web platform. We're going to talk about HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. There will be some Windows 8 topics that sneak into today, because it's definitely relevant. But then tomorrow is where we're going to dive into the Windows 8 platform itself.
Yeah. So when you think about today, I like how you said it. Think about that we're emphasizing all the good features of the web platform development, all those features. Yet at the same time, what we're really interested in doing is showing you how that's going to lead up into app development for tomorrow.
So absolutely.
Really excited about that.
Well, Michael's going to go ahead and get us started, and the topic that we're going to start with is HTML semantic structure.
Yes. So what do we mean when we say HTML5 semantic structure? Well, at the end of the day, there are so many people that are interested in web development and specifically right now the HTML5 content. And there is sometimes some mystery as to what does it mean to have semantic elements. So let's go ahead and dive in and take a look at our agenda. We're going to be focusing on semantic tags first, and then we're going to get into how the forms have changed a little bit with HTML5. cover some of the eye candy pieces, I guess you would call it, from HTML5 with the audio, video, canvas, and SVG. We'll sprinkle some demos in throughout. Let's start right now by considering this perplexing situation. Now, Jeremy, when you look at this and you see, you know, these divs with these IDs in these classes, do you think that this 3-4 years ago looked somewhat familiar?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It looks very familiar to me.
So, you know, and so did the powers behind HTML5. You know, they looked at this and realized there's so much repetition going on with people creating headers or navs or articles or whatever the case was. So why not do this and just formalize all those things that are typically done in web apps today? So these semantic tags are made available so that we can just say, hey, you know what, instead of having an ID or a class to kind of give that attribution, let's give it, make it a first-class citizen within the markup. So what are some of the new features or new semantic tags? We saw a couple in the previous kind of conceptual-looking graphic, but these are elements that map over. It gives an idea of what the block level would be or if it's text level and what its purpose is. But I find, of course, and I'm sure you're the same, that it's usually best to see in a demo. So I'm going to do that in just a moment. The other factor with HTML5 is forms. And I think there's a lot of exciting features that just came out with forms. So consider this particular situation where we have, you know, a classic form asking for name, email, site, and phone. Well, some of the new attribution would be allowing that text type for input to be marked as required. And you'll notice right now on the screen that the required attribute is standing alone by itself.
That's interesting.
How does that make you feel?
At first, it makes me feel a little bit non-standard.
Yes, it does feel that way. You know, and I want to highlight that because of that, a lot of people like to actually put the required equals and then still put like the word required in quotes, which you're allowed to do. But it will work that way, which is kind of interesting. All right, let's go back over here and check out email. So email is a classic thing that is asked for. Not only are we marking it as required, but we're also saying, hey, let's provide a little placeholder. A placeholder that says, let's give them an example. You know, kind of like a traditional watermark that you would just have in the background. So that's how easy it is to do now in HTML5. You can do the same thing here with site, type URL. And with phone, I thought I'd introduce that you could also, in addition to all the things we've talked about before, you know, like we can mark it required, placeholders, we can actually provide, you recognize what's in that pattern?
Yeah, it looks like a phone number.